Today, I want to talk to you about something called Enhance Details. This is a new feature in Lightroom Classic that was released in February of this year in version 8.2. The reason I'm telling you about this is because it's actually the follow-up to my last video. In that video, I compared the performance of Lightroom with some other RAW converters. The RAW files I used in the video were taken from a Fuji X-T2 camera. Lightroom's always had a problem processing RAW files from the Fuji XTrans sensor, but now they've fixed it. Or at least they have if you're using version 8.2. And if you're a Photoshop Camera RAW user, Adobe's also added the feature to that in the February release. But it's not just Fuji RAW files that this feature's supposed to improve. If you read the information about Enhanced Detail on the Adobe site, it says, "Powered by Adobe Sensei, Enhanced Details produces crisp detail, improved color rendering, more accurate renditions of edges, and fewer artifacts. Enhanced Details is particularly useful for making large prints, where fine details are more visible. This feature applies to raw mosaic files from cameras with Beyer sensors, Canon, Nikon, Sony and others, and Fuji XTrans sensors." So let's see how it really performs with some actual examples. The first image I want to show you that's on screen now is one shot with a Fuji X-T1 using an 18-135 lens. It's significant for me because this was the first time I'd used a Fuji camera. The results of processing this image using Lightroom at the time made me think the camera was actually faulty. At 2:1 magnification, you can see that the fine grass here just takes on a smeared appearance. Now let's use the Enhance Detail feature of Lightroom. You can select Enhance Detail from either the Photo menu or by right-clicking on the image. This is important because it's not something that you can turn on and off. To use Enhance Detail, you need to process each RAW file that you want to use it on separately. If I click on this image, you can see the Enhance Detail option. This displays a dialog showing a magnified preview of the RAW file. You can also zoom the preview out by clicking this magnifying glass icon in the bottom right corner. It's then possible to zoom into another area. As well as this, you can click and drag using the mouse. When zoomed in, the preview appears to be about 4:1 magnification, or that's about 400%. So keep this in mind if you're going to be using it to judge the results. If I click the Enhance button, Lightroom will generate an enhanced version of the image. This is created as a new RAW file, and it's in the DNG format. It's also got exactly the same settings as the RAW file that we processed. I'm not sure how well it will show on the video, but the detail is definitely clearer in the new RAW file. Having experimented a little with the new DNG files, they appear to respond differently to the original files in terms of sharpening and noise reduction. So don't just rely on your old settings to get the best from the new file. Now the image I'm showing here isn't really a good example because the lens I used did turn out to be faulty. Instead, let's have a look at a different example from my Fuji X-T2 camera that uses a different 18-135 lens. Here, I'm zoomed into an area of the image. You can see that the details in the fern and the bracken here look to be artificial in some way and almost like a drawing. Now I've also got a version of the file processed using Enhanced Details feature. When we look at the new Enhanced DNG file, we find the details that caused a problem in the original file now look much better. I've also processed both versions of this image and taken them into Photoshop so we can make a better comparison. If you watch the distant details, you can see the enhanced version improves the standard version. So I've got the standard version on screen at the moment, zoomed in at 200%. If I turn on the enhanced version, you should be able to tell that these areas here in the distance now appear to have much more natural looking detail than the original. It's only a subtle change, but it is actually quite clear when you're looking at it on your own monitor. And it's the same story when we look at the images I processed in my previous video. The standard version just appears to look false in the detail. Turn on the enhanced version, and all of a sudden it appears natural. But where things get really impressive is when we process an image from a high quality lens. This image was shot using my 10-24 lens, which is much better quality than the 18-135 in terms of what it can resolve. If we zoom into the detail here, and we take that up to 200%, this image was processed with the standard Lightroom processing. And now, this image was shot with the enhanced detail. And you can see that there's a little bit more detail being resolved in the image. And the same happens out in these mid-distant regions here. It also looks really natural now. If I turn this off and you look at the old version, it just looks a little bit more smeared and a little unnatural. Having made some comparisons, I'm reasonably confident the enhanced detail version now matches what I was achieving before using Iridian Text Transformer. But there may be some bad news as well. The feature is supposed to improve RAW files from lots of different cameras. Personally, I've seen very little difference except from when processing Fuji RAW files. I'm hoping that if you can try the enhanced details feature on your own RAW files, you'll let me know your thoughts in the comments. It'll be interesting to see if there are other cameras where the new processing makes such a large improvement as with the Fuji XTrans. I hope you found today's video useful. I'm Robin Whalley, you've been watching Lenscraft, I'll see you next time for another video.